I don't know about you guys, but I absolutely love teen dramas because there's always so much tea and it's hard to keep track.
Yeah, it feels like there's always so many twists and turns, and even though the shows usually make like no sense story-wise, like they're kind of like trash, I really just can't look away, like they're just so juicy.
But in a lot of teen dramas, there always seems to be a frenemy relationship, and that's incredibly toxic and is the base of the show. And those terrible friendships are what we're gonna talk about today.
Hey, what's up everyone? It's Mackenzie and Bree here, and today we're going to be listing the top 10 worst teen drama friendships. But before we get into that, make sure to subscribe to the channel if you like these videos and want to see more.
At number 10, Kitty and Marley from Glee. This friendship was so incredibly toxic. I mean, they didn't start off as friends before, but they grew to create some kind of bond that honestly should never have been there because of the way that Kitty treated Marley. Kitty was the reason for Marley's eating disorder. It started when Kitty began taking in Marley's costumes to make them smaller in order to make her think that she was gaining weight, and then preying on her insecurities, Kitty introduced her to bulimia, and things just snowballed from there. Marley stopped eating and was trying other unhealthy ways of losing weight, and it even got to the point where she fainted on stage during a huge performance with the Glee Club because she was so malnourished. It wasn't until later, after most of the damage was done, that Kitty finally confessed to Marley what she had done. This whole time, Marley thought that Kitty was her friend and that she was looking out for her, but instead she was really sabotaging her so-called friend. But before we get into the next one, make sure you guys like the video if you haven't already. It really helps us out.
Next up at number 9, we have Blair and Serena from Gossip Girl. Gossip Girl was a true cultural reset, and the show gained so much notoriety, it's still referenced to this day. By me for sure, maybe by other people as well. As well as influencing current TV trends. And at the center of the whole show was the friendly relationship between Blair and Serena. Two friends who have been BFFs since they could remember, but as they started to grow up, it became pretty clear that they were very toxic together. Firstly, they stabbed each other in the back countless times, and throughout the show, it seemed like they could never really trust each other. And personally, I think the most toxic person in the whole series in general is Serena Vanderwoodson. As we learned in the very first episode, Serena slept with Blair's longtime boyfriend, taking both of their virginities when Blair and Nate were saving themselves for each other. And the backstabbing only gets worse from there. And even though there are some nice moments, for the most part, their relationship is built on comparison and judgment.
At number 8, Bryce and Justin, 13 Reasons Why. Even though Bryce and Justin from 13 Reasons Why were supposed to be like brothers, they were far from that. Justin saw Bryce as someone who always had his back, and he was even the one who mourned his death the most. But Bryce was one of the worst friends there ever were. Not only did Bryce manipulate and use Justin for his own gain, but he also betrayed him and Jessica when he did what he did to her. Bryce was not only the reason for Jessica's suffering because of the incident, but also Justin's. He loved Jessica more than anything, and when their relationship was tarnished as a result of Bryce's actions, he not only lost a brother that night, but his girlfriend as well. Though Justin kept running back to Bryce time and time again when he needed help or a place to stay, he got it, but it was always at the cost of his loyalty to Bryce to support him in whatever matters befall him, which seemed to have messed with Justin's mind and emotions as he came to deal with some of Bryce's corrupt actions.
And at number 7, Rue and Jules from Euphoria. Although they seem like perfect friends who were helping each other out of dark times, a lot of turmoil and danger came from the friendship, as well as a lot of confusion for Rue in particular. In the beginning, Rue relied way too heavily on Jules, and she was really the only thing keeping her from going over the edge. But at the same time, Jules was pretty unreliable and untruthful to Rue, and she kept a lot of secrets from her that would have brought Rue a lot more clarity if they were shared. And even though the relationship turned romantic near the end, that didn't make it any better, and the series ends with the two of them deciding to run away together. But thankfully, at the last moment, Rue decides not to go through with it and chooses her family over her addiction to Jules.
At number 6, Betty and Veronica from Riverdale. This one might be a little controversial, but I'm going with it anyway. Riverdale's Betty and Veronica have a toxic relationship. Yes, they've had their moments of power together and they sometimes make a good team, but there's also been some shady stuff behind the scenes. Most notably, Betty's relationship with Archie. At the beginning of the series, it was hinted that Archie and Betty had feelings for each other, but those feelings were never realized as Veronica came into the picture and started dating Archie, and Betty started dating Jughead. But over the season, there have been some moments between Betty and Archie which have now climaxed into the most recent season where, spoiler alert, they've now started some kind of secret relationship thing, and now Veronica and Jughead have been blindsided. This came out of nowhere, but it's still not very nice for Betty to steal Veronica, her supposed best friend's boyfriend, from right under her nose.
Halfway at number 5, Adriana and Silver from 90210. 90210 is a show with so many frenemy relationships that it's really hard to keep track, but one of the most tumultuous is the relationship between Adriana and Silver. One of the nastiest things to happen between them is when Adriana discovered that Silver was sleeping with her boyfriend, and as revenge for this, Adriana ends up posting one of Silver's nudes online for the world to see. And then, when that wasn't enough, Adriana also switched Silver's meds for her bipolar disorder, which caused Silver to consider taking her own life. After all the drama between them, it's clear there was love between them, but they weren't compatible at all and probably should have never been friends.
At number 4, Puck and Finn, Glee. Finn and Puck have had a weird relationship. Though in the end the two were like brothers, there was still some backstabbing going on during their friendship as well. Most notably when Puck slept with Finn's girlfriend Quinn and accidentally got her pregnant. And as if that wasn't bad enough, they made Finn think that he was the father when in reality it was Finn who was. I mean, this was all some very dramatic and intricate storytelling for a bunch of high school schoolers, but I digress. The point here is that A, you don't sleep with your best friend's partner, and B, if something happens, you don't fabricate such an intricate lie like they did. Be honest about your mistake, and maybe you'll both sing about it and reconcile the way these two did.
In at number 3, The Plastics from Mean Girls. I really couldn't have made this list without talking about one of the most infamous groups of teen BFFs, The Plastics. That is of course referring to the group of girls in Mean Girls. And why they're called The Plastics? Well, on the one hand it can be because they're the closest thing to Barbie-like perfection, but they also can be referred to as being hard and cold, but still a little shiny. In Mean Girls, The Plastics are led by Regina George, the school's alpha female, with Gretchen Wieners and Karen Smith as her loyal sidekicks. In the movie, we see Regina be a terrible friend to all the girls, but Gretchen in particular, as she tries the hardest to be Regina's friend. Some standout moments were when Regina stops Katie from getting with her ex, Aaron Samuels, and makes Aaron think that Katie is crazy obsessed with him. Then when the girls do their Christmas dance, Regina demotes Gretchen, then puts her down when she tells her, quote, "Stop trying to make fetch happen, it's not going to happen."
At number 2, all of the girls from Pretty Little Liars. The girls from Pretty Little Liars have to be part of the worst friend group in TV history. Not only were they all fighting each other trying to figure out who amongst them was A, but they also had their quarrels with Allison starting from their childhood, as she created insecurities that they all faced later in life. Allison was manipulative and controlling of her friends, and with all of the drama between them after her disappearance and quote unquote death, the rest of the girls were just left with guilt and emotional trauma that stuck with them over the years. They all backstabbed each other at some point or another, and their friendship was just riddled with lies and deceit and scandal. I'm not really sure you can call them friends after what went down between them.
And finally, number 1, Brooke and Peyton from One Tree Hill. Brooke and Peyton are another friendship that was fraught with lies and cheating, with Peyton stabbing Brooke in the back multiple times by cheating on Lucas. Their friendship is so great at some points though, especially in season 4, when they're having sleepovers filled with good times. But in some other unsavory moments, Peyton punched Brooke in the face when she found out that Brooke slept with Nathan after they'd recently broken up. And to make sure that everyone knew, Peyton started slut-shaming her to everyone, and even painted the word whore on her prom dress. Also, Brooke made fun of Peyton's mom's death, and the two fought so bad that they got in a literal fist fight. So yeah, definitely very toxic. Alright guys, that's all for the video today. Let me know what you're thinking about it down below. Did you watch any of these shows, or were there any that we missed? Do you watch any of these shows? I heard you say Riverdale.
Oh yeah, Riverdale, Glee in the past, like way back then, but none of the other ones. However, I do have an honorable mention for this list. The girls from Heathers, because they literally killed each other.
Yeah.
I don't think it gets any worse than that.
I don't know what that is, but I kept seeing that, and I was like, I've never seen or heard of that, but they seem
watch
like
that
trash.
Movie. It's something else.
Alright, so now we're gonna shout out some comments from our last collab on worst reality TV fights.
Janelle Elizabeth says, if I ever go into a fight, y'all can bet I want Gordon Ramsay in my corner.
Yes,
he's definitely someone that you would definitely want to fight your battles.
He doesn't even need to do anything physical. He just like speaks to people until they cry.
Yeah, he's very intimidating.
Work on me, for sure. I actually used to have a teacher very similar to him, and he actually like made me cry a little bit one time. Not gonna get into it, but... Yeah. Then Imani said, the Bad Girls Club. You missed America's Next Top Model 2 when Tyra yells at one of the models during judgment. Did you not say that part where she was like, we're rooting for you, we're all rooting for you?
Yeah.
Or was that mentioned? Okay, then what other part?
I think that was a different video. Either way.
Yeah.
Tyra's yelling at everybody.
Yeah, no, she went awful on people in that show.
Sagar G says most of these shows aren't actually fully reality shows. It's production house who tells them what to do and how to do. That's why I don't trust these shows. You never know what happens behind the camera than before and after every scene. That is a very good point.
Mm-hmm. Very valid. I mean, they still feel more real. That's why I personally like them, even though you're right, like it's a lot of BS, but they just feel more real. I don't know.
But I would like to think that Gordon Ramsay's shows are 100% real, because I don't think he could really rehearse the things that he says.
Yeah.
I think it just comes out naturally.
Also, no one tells him what to do.
Oh yeah, so you don't tell him what to do.
That's like a second.
That's a no-no.
And then Sid Savage said, no one, Mackenzie. Okay, I can't read what that exactly said, but it was something like, what the heck? Because I was gonna say, you know, the other more common phrase, but when I was doing it, I was like, oh, is that gonna be bleep? So you can tell that little pause. I was like, what the? All right, guys, that is all for the list today. Thanks so much for sticking around if you made it all the way here. And if you liked, make sure to like and sub to the channel below. I've been your host, Mackenzie Smith.
And I'm Bree Room.
And we'll catch you in the next one.
Bye.